fire has been here before us and will be here after us. This is a forest that has really no respect for us. When the flames are in the treetops or the column is rising up and making its own thunderstorm cell, you realize that we are mortal and we are small in this world.
The Peri Fire in 2016 was the largest fire in Grand Teton National Park history. It was started by a lightning strike in the remote northwest corner of the park, but in late August, the fire began to spread more dramatically, jumping a mile over the north end of Jackson Lake. It closed the main highway between the Tetons and Yellowstone for 5 days, forcing visitors to drive hours out of their way. 2 weeks later, high winds pushed the fire 6 miles in an afternoon, past Flag Ranch and the south gate of Yellowstone. The smoke plume could be seen throughout the park, and some days the smoke was so dense you could barely see the mountains. Each morning, visitors awoke to red sunrises and the smell of fire.
All right, we should start seeing some lodgepole pine seedlings. It's sort of early. Oh, here's one. Here's a serotonous cone. You can see it's been opened up from the heat of the fire. And there is the forest of the future right there. After the snow melted and this black soil gets solar heat on it, the seeds sprout and little pine trees emerge. We'll probably find thousands of them.
I think for the visitor that's not used to seeing fire in the west, seeing a large column of smoke like we put up on the Peri Fire can be really scary or maybe unnerving. But it's important to know that fire has been a part of this ecosystem for a long, long time.
Fires, it's inconvenient, it's scary. We're keenly aware of the smoke and the road closures. But sometimes we have to remember that our Park Service mission, it's that twofold mission where we need to provide for enjoyment of the public, but we also need to take care of our natural resources for the future generations.
Lodgepole pines depend on fire to open their specially adapted serotonous cones and release their seeds. Scientists study the ways that fire shapes these forests, gathering data to help park officials better understand and manage fires. Over time, frequent fire forms a patchwork of habitats where different plants and animals can thrive. This pattern of open spaces, younger trees, and mature forest is more resilient in the long term and less susceptible to large fires.
Oftentimes, when we decide to manage a fire, yeah, it may have a lot of smoke and flames for 2 or 3 days, but long term, the risk is reduced to the ecosystem because fire has been allowed to play its natural role. And now, looking around us here, we might have a fire again, but it's not going to burn with the same intensity later. So sometimes it's a choice of pay me now or pay me later, is taking a little bit of smoke now versus maybe a larger fire if we keep postponing the inevitable.
We knew that there was a chance that the Peri Fire was going to cross the road, and we knew that there was a chance that the Peri Fire was going to come up to Flag Ranch. And so we were ready. Flag Ranch was ready. The rangers in the park were ready. It was a hard decision to make, to say, all right, we'll take this on for the betterment of the ecosystem.
Because we manage fires year after year after year, we have an ability to analyze the long-term probability. And that gave us some confidence that it would move towards the lake, but less than 5% that it would cross the lake. Towards the end of the fire season, it again did another 5-mile run. And again, that was predicted, but it was also at that 5%. So we're looking at 2 5% probabilities occurring in the same summer. And what that's teaching us is that in the conditions we are in now, 5% may be something we should plan for.
In our lifetimes, a big fire seems like a permanent alteration. But really, we have to think about a little bit more of a long-term time and space environment. And what it does is just create this landscape diversity and habitats for wildlife. And in that context, fires change is, it's still a little hard to take for us humans, but it's an important thing to perpetuate.
You're actually seeing nature at work, a natural process occur, just like you want to see a grizzly bear running around or a wolf trotting around chasing an elk. You're seeing nature play out in front of you. We wouldn't have any problems with bears if we got rid of all the bears, but it wouldn't be Grand Teton National Park.
People love trees, and so when trees are killed, it's kind of sad, but that's how we get new trees. In 5 years, these pines will probably be about this tall. In 20 years, they'll be up over my head. And in about 200 years, probably look like this.